Well, we mentioned that the Maulers come into this game with a record of 2 wins and 7 losses, and it's really been a very competitive year for the Pittsburgh Maulers. They've been in virtually every ball game. Maybe that's what makes it so frustrating, is they do arrive at that 2-7 mark. Let's turn back the clock now and begin at the beginning, see how this 1984 year has come to be.
The first year Pittsburgh Maulers have had an up and down season so far. In the beginning of the year, it was the Mauler defense which held the team together. The opener in Tulsa against the fellow expansion Oklahoma Outlaws was typical of the Mauler defense. Through horrendous weather conditions, Pittsburgh held the Outlaws in ambush, only to lose 7-3 in the fourth quarter. Week 2, and a date with the USFL champion Michigan Panthers. After an impressive opening drive, which gave the Maulers an early 7-0 lead, their defense went to work, giving Pittsburgh a 14-7 halftime advantage. But after a hard-fought 24-24 fourth quarter score, Panther place kicker Novo Bojovic kicked the game-winning field goal with 32 seconds left, and a disappointing 27-24 Pittsburgh loss. Week number 3 brought the return to Three Rivers of former Steeler quarterback Cliff Stout, and what a reception he got. The Mauler defense stopped Stout in the passing game, holding them to just 2 completions for 29 yards. What they didn't stop was Joe Cribbs, who gained 191 yards. Final score before a packed home crowd at Three Rivers, Birmingham 30, the Maulers 18. The menu of the next week was exactly what the 0-3 Maulers needed. The opponent, the hapless Washington Federals. After a 7-7 deadlock, which lasted through three quarters, the Maulers went ahead 10-7 with just 2 minutes remaining. Safety Jeff Delaney's interception and touchdown run with a minute 16 left gave the Maulers win number one. Now at 1-3, Pittsburgh hosted the division-leading Philadelphia Stars. Chuck Fusino riddled the Mauler secondary for 249 yards and 3 touchdowns, hooking up with Scott Fitzke for 8 pass completions and a 25-10 Stars win. However, it was a game where the Maulers' offense first showed signs of life. The addition of newcomer Jackie Flowers adding strength to the aerial game. While Mike Rozier had his longest run of the season. In the next game, the winless Oakland Invaders were celebrating Christmas early, turning the ball over 3 straight times in the first half to the Maulers, leading them to a 21-0 lead. However, when the Invaders attempted a comeback, the Mauler defense held strong, while the passing game, headed by Glenn Carano and Jackie Flowers, who caught 10, 4 for touchdowns, were devastating. It was win number 2. The 2-5 Maulers hooked up with the New Orleans Breakers in what undoubtedly was the most exciting game of the season. After being down 10 points, the Maulers staged a dramatic fourth quarter comeback. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns. And the Maulers did it impressively, moving long and quickly. But their comeback was upstaged by the Breakers' comeback of their own. New Orleans scored 10 points in under 3 minutes, the last 3 coming on a 41-yard field goal with just 17 seconds left, a heartbreaking 27-24 loss. As heartbreaking a loss that game was, the next was a shocker. It was the tale of two halves against Denver. All Maulers in the first half, a 21-0 halftime lead. All gold in the second half and a 31-21 loss. For Carano, he had now thrown 8 touchdown passes in his last 3 games, Flowers now had 23 catches in four games, while fellow receiving mate Greg Anderson now had 35 after eight games. Mike Rozier also had his first ever 100-yard rushing game of his brief pro career. Last Sunday, the 6-2 Herschel Walker-led New Jersey Generals waded into a downpour at Three Rivers Stadium. After dodging the bullet early, the Maulers forced New Jersey turnovers and held a 10-0 lead after three quarters. But the Generals behind Walker scored 14 fourth-quarter points and sent the Maulers to their seventh defeat.